class to students. Welcome back to English grammar class. Now, today we will learn sentences. In the previous day, we have learned sentence, the first word of this chapter, sentences. Okay, I hope have you done it. Sentences. Previous day, I have told you what is the sentence. Sentence is a group of words that express a complete sense, means complete meaning. In the previous class, we have learned it. Now, today we will learn another part of this chapter, capital letters and full stop, means how to use capital letters and full stop, or where should we put capital letters and full stop or question mark. Okay. Now, open at page number 11 of your book. Open at page number 11. Here are the rules. You should read the rules at home. But now, in this class, I will discuss the rules, how we will discuss the process, how to implement the rules. For example, capital letter. What is the first rule? One by one, I will describe the rule. A capital letter is used at the beginning of a sentence. For example, if I write it, we go to school. Go to school every day. What I have written? Go to school every day. Now, it's a sentence because it begins with a capital letter, ends with a full stop, and it gives us complete sense. But look at the W. This is the beginning. Now, the beginning of a sentence is you always capital letter. So, this is the first rule, how to use capital letter. Now, second rule, for special names of people, pets, places, rivers and mountains. For example, the special name of people. Now, I am writing another sentence. Tina lives in Jamalpur. What I have written? Tina lives in Jamalpur. Now, who is the special name here? Special name means particular name. In the previous class, we have read that particular name is called special name. Here is Tina. Tina is the special name for a girl. Yes, girl means, girl refers to any girl. But when I say Tina, Tina refers to a particular girl. And now, Jamalpur. We all know that our school is situated in Jamalpur. Jamalpur is the name of a place. If I say village or town, any village, any town. But if I say Jamalpur, it's the name of a place. Okay, Jamalpur is a special name. So name of person, special name for place. Now name of river or name of mountains. For example, we say river Damodar flows past our village. Now, river Damodar flows past our village. Damodar is the special name of a place. Sorry, it's the special name of a river. If I say river, river refers to any river. But if I say Damodar, it's the special name of a river. For the example, the name of mountain. If I write here, Mount Everest is the highest mountain peak. Mount Everest. Everest is the name of a mountain, hill, mountain. So Everest, capital letter. Next, third rules. For the names of days of the week and months of the year. We all know that we always write Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday in capital letter. And we always write the names of the 12 months, means January, February, Okay, January, February up to December, always in capital letter. So remember the names of months and the names of days, we should write in capital letters. Next, for the names of festivals and holidays. The names of festivals and holidays, let me describe the rule by giving an example. The names of festival and days. We celebrate Christmas. So Christmas is the name of festival. We celebrate Christmas on 25th December. What I have written, we celebrate Christmas on 25th December. Now, Christmas is the name of a festival, so we should write in capital festival. And December is the special name for months, M-O-N-T-H month, so it's also capital letter. Is that clear? For the special name of festival and for the special name of month, capital letter. And next, for the names of languages, means Bengali, Hindi, we always use capital letter for the names of languages. And the titles, when used with names, so when we say Dr. Vishwas, okay, Professor Rose, we always use D. When we say Dr. Vishwas, if I say I may Dr. Vishwas yesterday. Here you should use D capital. Why? Because the title is used with the person. The clear? So you always use capital letter. When we full stop, you all know that at the end of the sentence we must use the full stop. But why we don't use capital letters? Read the rules carefully. Remember the names of days, the names of months, we always use capital letter. But for the names of seasons, we don't use capital letters. The subjects like science and maths, when we write science and maths, we don't use capital letters. And professor and titles where they are mentioned along, like doctor or professor. For example, Mr. Vishwas is a professor, then we write professor P small. Okay, just rule the list. Now, tick the questions. If it is a question, you have to give a tick mark. Okay, what is question? One is statement and one is question. Statement refers when a sentence tells us something or states something, that is a statement. But when a sentence asks a question or asks something, that is a question. Now, what is the leap year? It's a question, so you should give the tick mark. My mother likes to collect teapots. It's not a question. So, cross. How long does it take to reach Manali? It's a question, so give the tick mark. You have to do it like this. So, CW and PW. Now, next, Kashmir is also called the paradise on earth. It's not a question statement, it's a cross. When do you go to sleep? It's a question, so give that tick mark. Okay, up to page number 12, it's your PW. That's all for the day. Have a nice day. Bye.